person who were out there walking around, sir.
But for rockets, just these two. For a missile, you also need
two. When you're trying to get on your park heading, when you get a mission, your park heading is like where your launcher is faced. It'll tell you which way to point your launcher so that it can properly point down in the direction.
Thank you. up. Alright, back.
What we normally saw with Vic was like a 3-foot tide. Not that was it, because the buoy was about 45 foot from where it should be to the chart. The captain kind of looks at that and said, this platform to load up to 12 JLTVs or mixed load one to the base. Have modules up on top of that, broken down on one.
Chasing the tides coming in. We can get into a position, we can stay there, we can chase the tide by just using the spuds. As long as self-supporting, meaning that the feet of the ramp have to be on something. The ground, a ship where we can take Marines to beaches. Well, as soon as we got one, is that it gives us a V-shaped hull. So the riding condition is much better for the crew.
Likely gonna be sensed via multi-means as you're, you know, putting stuff ashore and embarking.
And start vehicles offloading in about 35 to 40 minutes.
Is it hauling foot?
One, 4 years. One, 4 years. Mission planning is done from a point-and-click tablet, so our training module is only a couple of days.
Shipping-wise, it cuts the shipping space needed to one-third of the current.
So, yes, the sensors up top, we have this on 360 with us for about 5 years now.
They have been operating 11 years.
Project Convergence is a U.S. Army initiative to bring together joint and coalition partners to do experimentation, and then the Marine Corps participates by doing our modernization experimentation as well. The Stern Landing Vessel is a contractor-owned, contractor-operated vessel. It's used for mobility, sustainment, and potentially maneuver of stand-in forces in support of expeditionary advanced base operations. Transition from counterinsurgency operations, largely land-based, to expeditionary advanced base operations in mostly a maritime environment has created new challenges, new requirements, especially on the logistics side, understanding how do we support forces if they're distributed. They're going to require sustainment at intervals that are increasingly more difficult to solve, along with the distance that we're traveling. One other technology used at Project Convergence is the Unmanned Logistics System Air Maritime. The ULSA has an autonomy package allowing it to recognize a vessel and a target point to land on that vessel. This is different because normal drones have the ability to use a grid point to land on land, but for the Navy and Marine Corps team, it's important for us to be able to do ship to shore and then shore to ship. This is just one step in the campaign that we're conducting in order to understand the future capabilities we require to accomplish the force design goals set by the Commandant.